How was the mental shift of the more physical machining and the 3D model CAD done for 3D printing, like with the Mando rifle? How is the mental shift? Well, right. So what you're asking, I think, is because 3D printing isn't part of my normal process, did it require some mental gymnastics for me to incorporate it in the Amben rifle build? And the answer is, yeah, totally. In fact, I printed way more than I needed to for this rifle in order to kind of get to know it. So I did an initial pass of all of the pieces from the Etsy file I used in draft resin. And I even, before I got the printer, before I knew I was getting the printer, I sent off a set to a friend of mine who's got a sintered nylon printer. And I had a set of some of those parts done in sintered nylon. And in fact, one of them remains on this model. It's this one. This front triangular piece is not from that Etsy file that I used. It is the one piece from a different Mando build. But yeah, the mental shift was significant because in machining, like when you're machining something, you get to know it totally. You make drawings of every possible facet and then you work to cut each of those facets carefully using the, 3,000 pound thing behind me. When you're 3D printing, it takes a while to build the same amount of knowledge of each piece. And in fact, I found one of the most difficult things about 3D printing is simply the information management of it. This is what, probably 30 separate printed parts, maybe 40 separate printed pieces. And they're all named something like DB1004 dot blah, blah, blah. And it's like, what are you going to name each one like that little clip that's on the left? Well, first of all, yes, that is exactly how to name them using natural naming techniques because it's the only way you're going to unpack it later. But I was trying to manage information about 40 pieces when I didn't know what any of them were. And it wasn't enough for me to just go into the digital file and keep on scrolling through them and looking at them because I didn't understand how they fit together. And even when I looked at exploded diagrams, that still wasn't enough information for me to really understand how they went together. So in order to utilize the 3D printing into the process of this rifle, I needed to go through a set of stages where I kept on looking at the printed parts and putting them together and understanding how they went together and then thinking how I wanted to add structure to the insides of those things. Right? Because like, I didn't just want to glue these parts to each other. I wanted there to be some metal pieces that ran the length of this. And that required me to sort of continually put pieces together. It's this process that I do on every prop, right? Where I slowly get to know all the pieces of it. And then when I'm done, you could show me any piece and I know precisely where it is and where it goes. But it takes a while to get there. And it takes a different type of while to get there in 3D printing as it does in machining. So yeah, I had to kind of open myself up to some new mental gymnastics to get to know this rifle enough to build it. I like to point out that like, for me, building is, I have to understand the thing in my head before I complete it in the physical world. And the difficulty for me with 3D printing is that it starts in a virtual space. I don't have the actual object in my hand. So far in the 3D printing that I've done, there's always a first pass of some scrap parts just for me to get to know the set of pieces that I will be using. And then when you're starting to print stuff and the prints take like 3 or 4 days and you've loaded 25 parts onto the plate in order to print them, and then you're loading another 25, and are you doubling up any or are you missing any? And how do you make sure of that? Yeah, it's non-trivial. And yet, reader, we achieved something at the end, an unphotographable piece that I am very, very happy with. I'll put this back here. I think that is a great place to stop. Thank you guys for joining me for May the 4th. May the 4th be with you and yours on this fine day. I hope everyone in your life and your loved ones and your friends are healthy. I hope that you are vaccinated and that you are getting to see those friends. I hope you get as much pleasure from the Star Wars universe as I do, because it's a lovely place to visit and to spend some time. And thank you guys for spending this time with me. I'm Adam Savage here in my cave. This is the end of my live stream. And as always, I will see you guys next time.
Thank you guys so much for watching that video. If you'd like to further support us here at Tested, one of the best ways you can do it is through a Tested membership. And there's a link below as to the various levels of Tested membership, but it's so much more than just exclusive videos. There are exclusive videos, but there are also live stream Q&As. And the thing that I love most about the Tested members is the interactivity, the wonderful communication between not just me and Tested members, but our whole Tested team. Every single day, it feels more and more like a community just devoted to the joys of making things. So join yourself up and become one of us.